If you've ever wondered why I'm so perky in the morning, this is why. The Clever Bean, it's my neighborhood coffee shop with two friends that run it, and it feels like family here. This is Dennis and Creighton. They've been in business now 9 months, and they're showing some of their favorite items to order. You two, I haven't had either one of these. What are we looking at?
Yeah, that's an affogato on the right. We put 4 scoops of ice cream. After lining the martini glass with some Ghirardelli chocolate sauce, we put some chocolate whipped cream and 2 shots of espresso. So the best chocolate coffee sundae.
Is that normally what you get? I mean, you don't see this at every coffee shop.
No, we did an exploration trip to London, and that's where it was inspired. I actually got an affogato in a martini glass and thought, whoa, that'd be really cool to have in our shop. So that's what inspired that drink.
I see it ordered every time I come in. Someone is ordering this affogato.
Affogato.
Affogato. Yep. Why did you two open this together, and what's the last 9 months been like?
Oh, they've been fantastic. It's been an unbelievable exploration trip in just kind of personal growth and development. The reason that we opened it is we both want to do something entrepreneurship-based. We were really looking at a couple different businesses, but we love the community that coffee created. And so we really wanted to focus and double down on community, human connection, and everything that goes along with that. We thought a coffee shop was the best way to approach it.
But you have to create a community, you two. You can't just walk in and have one. You have to establish one in Sandy and Draper. How did you do it?
We use a lot of social media, actually, a lot of Instagram, even Snapchat, and we try to be our authentic selves, and the way that we put out content is really just owning our mistakes. When we break things, we put it on social media, and we're, you know, just trying to be ourselves and be able to share that so that we can kind of knock down walls and have real human connections with other people.
These two aren't just throwing you coffee. They're asking you how your day was. It's so true. Do you call them customers, or is everyone in here your friend?
It's more friendship, but it's weird too, because now for the first time in my life, we have friends that pay us. So that's really fantastic.
I paid you several times.
It's been great. No.
Okay, what's this one we keep showing? What's this guy?
So on the right side, we've got there a Royal Hot Chocolate. So this was another drink inspired by Dennis's trip to London. Basically, what we decided is we wanted a really fancy hot chocolate, but we wanted to do something on the deeper side. So we went with a drinking chocolate. We use a local drinking chocolate called Solstice, and they've been fantastic to work with and partner. But basically, it's a drinking chocolate topped in with a chocolate whipped cream and some shaved chocolate bites.
Coffee's not just for morning anymore. I've actually been here after dinner several times. And is everyone else doing the same?
Yeah, some people do the same. I think you can have coffee any time of day.
Like whatever time it is, it's time for coffee?
Yeah, even late at night.
You two, how have you gotten along 9 months working together, starting this business from the ground up? Do you have your moments where you're like, I don't know if I can do this?
Well, we were childhood friends in Grand Junction, Colorado, and lost contact for 10 years before we reconnected. And so we did have that and some history, but coming to this, our whys and our passions have been really aligned since the very beginning. And being able to redevelop our relationship has been fantastic. And something that it just seems like we're definitely trying to go for the same goals overall.
Caffeine brought them together. And then everyone visiting the Clever Bean is keeping them here. One more drink. It's one of your favorites. Run back there. And this, what's he making? What's he putting together?
So this is actually one of our favorite drinks here. We did a lot of research on our cold brew. And so cold brewing is basically replacing heat with time. So as opposed to being a 4 to 5 minute brewing process, this is actually a 20 hour brewing process. We serve our cold brew best with some caramel and a little bit of half and half, which you'll see right here. Creates a very cool color effect. And we actually offer this in growlers as well. So if you want to take it home, it's a very easy option for the morning. You can just grab it straight out of your refrigerator, make it yourself.
It's so visually fantastic. Look at that. Is it art or do you drink it?
Oh, we drink it. So I would call it culinary arts, but I still don't know, because when you eat your artistic piece, what does it really count as?
The Clever Bean, everybody. Dennis, get over here next to your creation. You can't walk away now. Get over here. They are located in Draper. We're right on 7th East and 114 South. Go to our website. We'll link you to all of their information. They are on social media, like they said. They're posting all the time. I didn't tell you I was going to ask you to do this, but Dennis also beatboxes.
Oh, yes.
Can you beatbox us out of here? Do you mind? Ready, take it away.
You kidding me?
Clever.
Good till I did the raise the roof, and then it just went downhill like, from there.
Oh my gosh, I just want to drink one of their coffees.
They're amazing, everything they have there. The Clever Bean, that's their address right there on your screen, and of course Instagram and Facebook at The Clever Bean. Come in and you'll probably see me with my skinny vanilla latte. Up next, everybody, how to find your family roots, Bri.
As long as you're not raising the roof, I think we're good.
Sorry.